Aya, I'm honestly like so impressed with her. Like she was talking me up. Emily has a lot of pessimism. She's not the person who's like, this is how we're gonna do this and fix this. She's like, well, this is why we can't do this and can't do that without bringing a single idea. Emily is throwing my name out there. Her gameplay is just, it's crazy to me. I'm at the point now that my trust level for her is less than zero, but a vote for Brendan is very possible. He's been so bad in challenges, that is an easy vote that I'm still kind of tempted, if I'm not gonna lie.
I said it to Sabaya, if everyone wants to do Brendan, we could do Brendan. But Emily, I feel like if we take her to a swap or a merge, I think she's gonna be
strong. Bouncing. She is not loyal.
But the most important part when you're facing a challenging decision is to make a decision.
So I'm on board either way.
Yeah, I'm on board either way.
There's pros and cons to each. So if we wanna just go Brendan, I'm on board.
We have been the Lulu losers so far. We haven't won Jack. And so my goal with this vote is to not only come back stronger for the next challenge, but to also make sure that I build the strongest coalition that I take into the next part of the game. I think I'm really starting to get Emily. She is somebody who likes to go by facts and the numbers. The problem with Emily is she has a big mouth, but she can't get out of her own way.
You know, I don't have very many cards at this point. What can I do to build that trust?
I think just try and keep like the strategizing lower.
Yeah.
People are hating on her, but all I'm thinking to myself is, how can I possibly help? And maybe I can nurse her back to health. Nurse her as a stronger, better player.
I want to look out for you.
Okay.
But for now, just be helpful, be positive, mm-hmm. You know, and like sharing stories about yourself, mm-hmm. Like it's going to really help, you know?
Yeah.
But I just feel like it's just like,
it's what the tribe needs right now. I think I brought a bazooka to a tea party, and I need to put the bazooka down.
A bad player is going to want to continue to isolate her, continue to make sure that she knows that she's on the outs, and don't even try and talk to me.
I want to play with you, and I hope you can see me as an asset. You're the only person who's talked to me, really.
A good player is probably going to realize that everyone needs an ally, and Emily doesn't have anybody. And I'm the person who's being the most upfront with her, that I think that I'm making really good inroads. This tribe is so bad. We're like the Cavaliers when LeBron left the first time. We suck. We can't win anything. This tribe is falling apart. Emotionally, physically, everything. Emily's playing it smart, and I'm standing there being like, you're doing a great job, you know? Like, she's listening, it's working, and I think having Emily as an asset is going to be a very valuable thing for me.
And we'll have each other back, okay?
Awesome.
And I hope John and Sabaya realize we can actually work with Emily deeper into this game. This is like the island of misfit toys that I'm living on. Emily practiced again tonight. Probst was reading out the votes, and there was only two that he read. And she was like, Sabaya, do you not have a vote tonight? Just immediately picking a fight with the one person she's not supposed to pick a fight with. Old Emily is just bubbling right there underneath the surface. Like, she's not gone, right? But she is getting better and smarter. And Emily is somebody who I think knows that she has a home with me, and I'm gonna be the most real with her out of anybody on this island. We won the challenge, and my tribe chose me to go to the camp raid. So here I am, geared up, going to the boat, and what do I see on the boat is a little script.
What's this?
In addition to stealing one item from the tribe, you also have an opportunity to forge a secret relationship with another player. You must give this goodwill advantage to one player. This advantage allows them to restore one lost vote. Good luck. The goodwill advantage means that if somebody loses their vote, they get to retain their vote. They get to cancel out that loss. So not only am I coming to the tribe and trying to make a friend, but I have a gift to be able to give them. Who doesn't love gifts? In sales, when everyone's having a good time, they tend to let their guard down a little bit more, which gives you more opportunity to be able to capitalize.
So what brings you here?
It's a raid. We thought it just made sense to grab the fishing gear. Is that all right?
What fishing stuff are you thinking of taking?
We're supposed to get the entire set, mm-hmm. But we would leave behind the spear. This isn't about trying to, like, absolutely pilfer you guys.
Yeah.
Throughout the entire time of meeting them and getting the pleasantries out of the ways, all I'm thinking to myself is, how can I put this goodwill advantage to use? You know, would it be cool if I, like, met with some of you guys individually, maybe have, like, a little bit more genuine sense? You know, it's hard to kind of, like, talk to everybody. You know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure.
What information can I gather to make a decision? Drew telling me that, yes, he went to the journey, and yes, he got an advantage. It means that he's a player in this game, and I like that. Today was a really good day. I was ecstatic about how this raid went. I think not only did I maximize the supplies, I maximized the absolute most amount of information that I could have gathered. Man, that was a huge fall. Deep in my gut, I feel that the only reason Lulu won the reward was so that we can have the inevitable fall that we always have coming into the immunity challenge and losing once again and once again going to tribal council. We're going to be moving down to 3 people while everybody else has full teams. It's crazy. I can't believe this is happening.
Now we gotta go to tribal again.
God. Nobody imagines this is what their survivor journey is going to look like, you know?
I know.
Sean and Sabaya, we're gonna go after Emily. And as much as I wanna work with Emily, I don't think I can save her. It may be smarter to try and work with Sean and Sabaya and be able to try and make it to the next stage of the game. Emily says, hey, the votes are against you. Do I believe that 100%? Not necessarily, because Sabaya's plan was to tell Emily to vote me out tonight. And I really do believe that Sabaya and Sean want to work with me. So even though I absolutely am a possibility of going home tonight, I don't think that's how it's going to go.
There's a chance this is a 2-2 vote.
For this. Okay, I promise. Okay.
Yeah, and if it's a 2-2 vote, we both book Sean and say, look,
we're switching.
So you need to get on board. Yeah.
Okay.
Right now I have 2 options in front of me. I can ride with my alliance and take out Emily. Alternatively, I can vote out Sabaya. It'd be a big, big, big move. But what happens if there's a tie? What happens if Sabaya gets her vote back? I actually haven't fully made a decision yet here as I'm sitting here in this forest in terms of what I'm going to do. I've really built myself into 2 different sides, and it's now up to me to decide what I'm gonna do about it. I feel like Emily's the first person I can say I actually trust, because Sean and Sabaya were targeting me. So when she had a very real opportunity to come after me, she chose not to. It was awesome. Considering how much work I've spent investing in Emily these last 7 days,
I will say, like, I'm not naive. Like, she was running things around here.
Yeah.
She was calling all the shots.
And now it's Emily and I and Sean, who's been cowering with his tail between his legs, talking about how Sabaya has been controlling him this entire time. No one's buying it. So looking at the tribe, for me, it looks really bad because it's 4 Bello, 1 Lulu, but this is where I've been this entire game. Back on the bottom, have to work my way up. Nothing I haven't done before.
I'm gonna get you guys maybe some utensils.
You are such a hospitable host.
My job right now as the lone Lulu member is to be the most trustworthy and likable person to be able to bring into alliance as possible. I don't think that Jake overly trusts me right now, but I think he's open to a relationship. He wanted me to know that anybody was on the table, which is of course music to my ears. The conversation with Katara was fast and very insightful.
I'm looking for somebody that I can be like, all right, we got the common goal. Let's get to the merge. If we need to do something, we're gonna have to make a move at some point.
Yeah.
And I honestly believe if we all move against Bruce, Bruce will move against us.
We were at the water well, but I was no longer thirsty. I was finally quenched. Somebody's finally telling me what's going on around here. Knowing that Katara and Bruce might be at odds tells me already where some of the divisions might lie. And I feel like I finally am seeing how this forest is shaping. And now it's time for me to build the trail that I'm gonna walk down. I can't believe we won a challenge. This is how I feel on the inside, you know what I mean? A little, right? When we finally had some competent people on my tribe, I don't need to be on the Warriors. You know, I could be Kawhi Leonard, just put me on the Raptors. Put me on a halfway decent organization, and I know we can win games. And so I finally have some players who know how to win a team challenge, and it just felt great to do what I knew I could do and not feel like a crazy person continuously losing. Not having fire until night 9 is unprecedented. I was excited to burn away all of those bad juju vibes. It's almost like sage was burnt at my camp, and now I can start to look forward like a regular player in this game.
What a day. This is my favorite day on Survivor, I swear to you guys.
And right now, I'm just so glad I'm not Sean. I'm a big fan of the law of attraction, but the most important part of that is action. It's the last part of the work.
I want to work with you long into this game.
Yeah.
Seriously.
Me too. I love that.
Yeah.
To me, my focus has to be one-to-one relationships.
I like this.
You know, my superpower is getting people to work with me, you know, and to build trust.
I just want to make sure you're good, because you know you're good.
We're so good. But the one person I haven't had a connection with is Kelly. Every single person wants to work with Kelly.
Kelly seems to be like this person who everyone is like interested in talking to.
That is correct.
I think the best thing that we could do is love up on Kelly.
If I could partner with Kelly, that's where I'd actually have the most control in this game.
I'm going to be honest with you, just in the spirit of the fact that I didn't want to work with you. There was an idol here. Sabaya had it? Yeah, it's gone.
Bro, you're dropping bombs right now.
I told Kelly really valuable information. It's one of the last nuggets I was having in my pocket. I want to keep her as close as possible because I think that Kelly's the best player on this tribe.
And honestly, I feel it makes the most sense for us to, to kind of like stick together.
100%, dude.
You know what I mean? Like,
that's hug it out.
And I want her to know that Caleb is not a name that needs to get sung anytime soon. Bruce is a bossy leader. He's saying, hey, Caleb, go find coconuts. As I'm going fishing, as I'm climbing trees to get coconuts, he's like, well, actually, can you chop it as well?
Yeah, just keep going. Don't slow down. No.
Yes, sir. It's frustrating, but if you can't bend the knee to your enemies, doesn't matter what you do. They'll see you coming from a mile away. I want Bruce to know that I'll do anything he says, because when the time comes to strike, my hope is that he never sees it coming. Since the swap, I've been building some goodwill with these people. Now, my number one focus is to find the idol. But if I can't have the idol, I'd rather know who has it. So I want the rest of my tribe to also be looking. I can't believe I made it to this beach. I don't know what's crazier, being here or being here with Emily as my number one ally. I can't believe that Emily made it this far. She was so bad to start the game, but I can see she's really coming to her own.
Should we go see?
She is an ally that I can truly trust in to be able to navigate the rest of this game when we're the only two people on Lulu left. And hopefully we get to be the swing boats that are pulled into either Bello or Reba. I know Emily is somebody who's trustworthy to me, so that makes her the most valuable person to me right now. And Emily's already in with Reba. She's already worked with them on a boat. And I've been with Bello since the swap. So there's a lot of opportunity for us to get information and play both sides, hopefully without getting caught in the middle. My focus at this point is to present the most trustworthy and likable version of Caleb. So I'm selling myself and what I want people to see, not this monster who's coming to destroy all the players in the game, which is true, by the way.
I'm totally down if you guys are picking like a Bello or a Reaper. You know what I mean?
I've been able to work the whole group. We're vibing. I might look like the Golden Retriever on the outside, but they should never let me in their home. Bruce is mad at me for having conversations with people who aren't Bello. It was like I was a guy who got pulled over by a cop, getting shaken down for every piece of information and telling me how wrong I was when I didn't even do anything.
If you want the original Bello to do their thing together with you, then you have to seriously do some damage control.
Okay.
And that's gonna help me, it's gonna help you, it's gonna help Bello, and we're gonna go from there to pull one person in.
He has a very archaic way of looking at the game. He wants us to not talk to the enemy. And I think that's the stupidest thing ever.
I appreciate what you're saying. Please, obviously, keep it as much as you can on the low.
Oh, of course.
Now I'm going to try and just do it.
Who would I talk to? Nobody's talking to me, so you're good. 100%.
If Bruce doesn't trust me, I don't trust Bruce. It's that simple. Loserville, population 6. As they go wash off their mud, we're sitting there in the shelter like cattle, just wondering which one of us is going to get picked next. They have all of this power.
I came out here to play a strategic game. I was going to try and lower my threat level.
And they're coming after me. Of course they're coming after me. And I'm doing everything I can to stop it.
I'm just going to say something to you guys.
Yeah.
It takes a lot of putting faith in you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Bruce does have an idol.
You're kidding.
Yeah, he has it.
So what do I do? Guess what? Bruce has an idol, and I'm not working with him. I'm not working with any of Bello. I want to work with you guys. And I'm trying to rally Reba to get rid of Jay.
Oh, you guys do this with me?
I think we're good.
Yeah, we're good. Yeah, and I swear to you guys, I'm 10 toes down in this.
This is exciting.
Okay.
What we had back at that Lulu Beach, it's done. You go with the masses. We have to both kill them.
Is there anything else you feel like would really work with these people?
Selling myself and selling my case is not something I'm unfamiliar with in sales. However, people can sense desperation, and I am bleeding at this point with it. I feel like I'm about to throw up. My life is completely on the line.
We'll see what happens.
You'll be okay.
I have to hope that the numbers go my way. I need a group to work with. You can't run through this game by yourself like a vigilante. I'm not Batman, you know? I'm Caleb. I'm the Canadian. People at home would call me a pretty lucky guy. And tonight, they are absolutely correct. I appreciate everybody as well, like the respect, compassion the whole time, letting me fight at the day, tribal council. It's easy to bully the guy at the bottom, it feels like. And I just appreciate the way you guys handled it. Yeah, I know it's 12 votes, but we'll be okay.
I mean,
we'll be all right.
Okay. Nothing but respect.
Yeah. Tonight, they tried to write me off. Every single person on this entire tribe voted against me.
Has that ever happened? 12 votes?
This might be a record.
I think this is a record.
Dude, that's insane.
That's insane. I don't even know. I'm so late.
I was completely shocked. When they said save, my mouth dropped.
The first time a shot in the dark has been played correctly when somebody was supposed to go home. First time 12 votes have ever been canceled out, and I was this close to going home. So, big picture, I have a couple of people I think I can maybe trust, but ultimately, I don't have any friends here. Every moment I'm on the beach with Bruce, it's apparent to me that he's only played the game for about 14 hours before coming here.
But I have to find a way to work with him.
I want to reassure Jake that I can work with Bruce. But I had one of the most frustrating Survivor conversations of my life with Bruce, and I don't care what his viewpoint is.
Like, okay, you threw a pick. Check.
And it's taken everything inside of me to try and work with this guy since Bellow Beach.
Because when you're quarterback of a team, now you're thinking that the other 10 guys on that side of the ball are going to be like, oh, what the hell? Dylan's going to throw another pick. He's got to throw another pick. He threw one last time.
I feel like one of his kids. And I don't know how I made it 28 years without Bruce telling me what to do.
Austin does know about Bruce's idol, and Katora doesn't. And Katora is the third vote that we need at this tribal council. And so, if we let Austin share that information with Katora, she might flip on our entire alliance and end our game before we even have a chance to begin. Jake and Katora are ready to fight for me. The big thing that I learned over the last 24 hours here on Survivor is that the quantity of options is not nearly as important as the quality.
You just know who your people are when you need them.
Yeah.
When you really think about how serious a word trust is, it means having a strong alliance of multiple people that you will do anything for. If you show that type of loyalty, then you will get it in return.
Right when I thought my game was about to take a turn, I got voted out. And I couldn't have played a more different game than the one I thought coming onto this beach. First member of the jury, not at all the place that I wanted to go, but I never gave up that I fought until the very end. And so I am really proud of how I pushed through this game.